जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। स्टूडेंट्स, हेल्थ इज द मोस्ट प्रीशियस थिंग। हेल्थ डज नॉट कम फ्रॉम मेडिसिन, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इट कम्स फ्रॉम द पीस ऑफ माइंड, हार्ट एंड सोल। इट कम्स फ्रॉम लाफ्टर एंड लव। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इवेंचुअली कीप स्प्रेडिंग हैप्पीनेस, गिव हैप्पीनेस टू अदर्स एंड गेट हैप्पीनेस इन रिटर्न। दैट शुड बी द मोटो इन योर लाइफ। So students, let's start with the session. Today we are going to discuss some numericals based on the formulas which we have derived in the earlier sessions. We have derived two formulas for the refraction at concave and the convex spherical surfaces. The two formulas were when the object is placed in the rarer medium and then when the object is placed in the denser medium. So today we will be discussing some numericals based on those two formulas, right? So let's start with the first one. A small point object is placed in air at a distance of 60 cm from the convex spherical refracting surface of refractive index 1.5. So basically, this is a convex refracting spherical surface and we have considered the refractive index of the denser medium to be mu 2 and it's given to be 1.5, and that of air, it is 1. This will be the pole and this will be the center of curvature. Line joining P and C will be the principal axis, right? And the object is placed in air at a distance of 60 cm. Suppose this is where the object is placed. So this will be the direction of the incident ray. This is the direction of the incident ray, isn't it? So students, here in this case, PC, it is measured along the same direction as that of the incident ray. So it is to be taken as plus R. So it would be equal to plus 25 centimeter. Right? Now object distance U. PO is the object distance. It is measured in a direction opposite to that of the incident ray. So as per the sign convention, it has to be taken as negative. So it is minus 60 centimeter. Mu 1 is 1 and mu 2 is 1.5. And most important point is the point object is placed in air, that is rarer medium. So we are aware whenever the object is placed in the case of a rarer medium, then the formula to be used is minus mu 1 over u plus mu 2 over v is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. This is the formula to be used, right? So these are the values given. We are supposed to calculate the position of the image, that is V is to be found, and the power of the refracting surface. This term on the right hand side, students, this represents the power. We have discussed this is the term which gives the measure of the degree to which the refracting surface can converge or diverge the rays of light passing through it. So this is known as the power of the spherical refracting surface, right? So let's first calculate the value of V. So let us substitute the values. So minus mu 1 is 1, u is minus 60, plus mu 2 is 1.5 divided by v is equal to 1.5 minus 1 divided by 25, right? So what we get is 1.5 divided by v, it would be equal to, this is 0.5 divided by 25 minus 1 by 60. Or students, 0.5, that is, it will give us 1.5 divided by V is equal to 1 by 300. Which implies that V is equal to 1.5 multiplied by 300. So 15,345 and 450 centimeter with positive sign. The point to be noted over here is, students, V is plus 450 centimeter. Plus means V is positive. It means that the image will be formed on the other side as that of the object. Image will be formed somewhere over here. So PI would be positive.
So it means that image is formed on the other side as that of the object. Object is in the rarer medium, so the image is formed in the denser medium. So therefore, the real image is obtained. The nature of the image is real. So this is the position of the image, right? So it will be formed at a distance of 450 centimeter in the denser medium from the pole. Now regarding the power. Power of the refracting surface, I've told you, it's given by this particular expression, right? It is mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by r. So it is 1.5 minus 1 divided by 25. So it is 0.5 divided by 25, right? So it is equal to, and 25, it's in centimeter. So if you wish to calculate the value of power in SI, so you have to convert this centimeter into meter. R is 25 centimeter, or it will be equal to 0.25 meter. So don't forget to convert the value of R in SI. So what you get is 2 meter inverse. And meter inverse is also known as diopter. It can be represented as capital letter D. So this is the power. Again, power is positive. It means that the nature of the refracting surface is converging, right? It is a convex refracting surface. So we have calculated both the position of the image as well as the power of the refracting surface. Let's proceed to the next question. Next question is very interesting one. As per the second question, it's given that a small piece of paper stuck on a glass sphere of 5 cm radius is viewed through the glass from the position directly opposite. Suppose this is the piece of paper which is stuck on a glass surface of radius given to be 5 cm, right? And it is viewed from a position directly opposite. So this is the position of the eye of the observer, right? We are supposed to find out the position of the image. And the refractive index of the glass is 1.5. This is the denser medium. It is 1.5. It is placed in air whose refractive index is 1. Right? Let's draw the ray diagram first. Suppose this is the point where the refraction is to be studied. So we need to draw a normal over here. So any line joining the center of curvature to the point on the surface will act as a normal, right? This dotted line represents normal. This is the object. So, ray is incident at this point. Suppose this is point A. So, OA represents the incident ray. This one will be the angle of incidence. Now, the ray is traveling from denser to rarer. So, it will bend away from the normal, right? It will bend away like this. This is the refracted ray, and the angle which the refracted ray makes with the normal is the angle of refraction. And another ray, which is incident normally on the pole from the object, it will remain undeviated. These two rays will enter the retina of the eye and will create the sensation of sight, isn't it? So, if you produce this refracted ray backward, then it will appear to be coming from a point somewhere over here, like this. So as a result, the image is found to be formed somewhere over here and produce this refracted ray also in the backward direction. So these two refracted rays which enters the eye will appear to be coming from a point somewhere over here. So this is where the image is formed. Clear, students? So here, students, this is the incident ray. This is the incident ray, the direction of which is from left to right. This is the incident ray. So here, the incident ray is traveling in the denser medium. So the formula to be used can be obtained simply by interchanging this mu1 with mu2 in this particular formula. This was the formula which is applicable when the object is in the rarer medium. So in this case, since the incident ray is traveling in the denser medium, so the formula to be used is, it can be obtained by simply interchanging mu1 and mu2. So in place of mu1, write mu2. In place of mu 2, write mu 1. In place of mu 2, mu 1, and in place of mu 1, write mu 2. So this is the formula to be used over here. Right? Now let's make use of the sign convention. Over here, students, mu 1, refractive index of the rarer medium, that is 1. Mu 2, refractive index of the denser medium, that is 1.5. U is the object distance. This is the pole. Incident rays traveling from left to right. And here PO is measured from right to left in a direction opposite. So it will be negative. And this is 5 cm radius. So the diameter would be 10 cm, isn't it? So the diameter would be 10 cm. As the radius, it's given to be 5. So it will be U is minus 10 cm. V, it is to be found. And radius of curvature. Now again, radius of curvature is PC. All the distances as per the convention is to be measured from the pole. PC is measured in a direction opposite to that of the incident ray. So PC is equal to R. It will be negative, minus 5 centimeter. Let's substitute these values over here. What we get is minus 1.5 divided by U is minus 10 plus 1 by V is equal to mu 1 is 1 minus 1.5 divided by R is minus 5. That is 1.5 divided by 10 plus 1 by V is equal to 0.5 divided by minus 5, which further implies that 1 by V, it would be equal to, this will be 15. It will give us 0.5 divided by minus 5. And it will be negative, students. 1 minus 1.5 is minus 0.5. Minus minus get cancelled. So we will be left with 1 by 10. And this term, when taken on the other side, its sign will get changed. So it will give us 15 by 100, isn't it? It will be 15 by 100. So, 3 by 20. 5, 3 is 15 and 5, 20. 5 into 20 is 100. So, it will be 3 by 20. So, that will give us 20 can be taken as LCM. And over here, we will get 20 minus 30. Isn't it? 20, 10, 2. So, it will be 2. Minus 3. So it is minus 1 by 20. Or students, V is equal to minus 20 centimeter. The negative sign suggests that image is formed on the same side as that of the object, isn't it? And the negative sign also suggests that the image formed is rarer. Image formed is in the rarer medium, so it is virtual in this case. It is formed on the same side as that of the object. So the nature of the image is virtual. So students, this is the appropriate ray diagram for this particular question, right? Now let us proceed to question number 3, which is an interesting one, very, very interesting one. An empty spherical flask of diameter 15 centimeter is placed in water of refractive index 4 by 3. So this is water of refractive index 4 by 3, right? And inside it is air, obviously, it is one rarer medium. Now, a parallel beam of light strikes the flask. Where does it get focused when observed from within the flask? So students, imagine yourself to be within the flask, right? Now this figure shows a spherical flask placed inside water. Now as such, the flask inside the water, it will behave as a concave refracting spherical surface. So obviously it is acting as a concave spherical refracting surface. This is the denser medium and this is obviously the rarer medium, air. And this is the center of the flask, which will also act as the center of curvature of the concave spherical surface. Now let us consider, these are the two points Suppose these are the two points where a parallel beam is incident, right? Now, in order to show refraction, we need to draw a normal. Normal means line drawn from the center of curvature to the given point on the surface. So it has to be represented by dotted lines. These are the normals. It has to be represented by dotted lines. Now, as per the question, a parallel beam of light strikes the flask. So this is the parallel beam of light, which is striking the flask at these two points. So these are the parallel beams, so they must be coming from infinity, isn't it? And this will be the angle of incidence, obviously. Due to symmetry, this will be also angle I. Now here, students, the ray is traveling from denser to rarer medium. So it will tend to bend away from the normal, like this. So this will be the refracted ray. This will be the angle of refraction. Similarly, at this point, the ray of light will again bend through the same angle. So this is the refracted ray. Denser to rarer, it will bend away from the normal, right? This will be the angle of refraction. Now these are the two rays which will enter the eye, and it will appear as if these two rays are coming from a point somewhere over here, right? So what to do is, we produce these two refracted rays in the backward direction, like this. So it will appear as if these two rays are coming from a point somewhere over here. So let us produce it in the backward direction. So when the refracted rays 1 and 2 enter the eye, then it will appear as if these two rays are coming from a point over here. So this is where the image will be formed. This is the position of the image, right? So students, now let's discuss the formula to be used over here. This is the incident ray, isn't it? This is the incident ray which is traveling in water, which is the denser medium. So here, the formula applicable for the denser medium is to be used. So the formula applicable over here is minus mu 2 over u plus mu 1 over v is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 by r. This is the formula for the object when placed in a denser medium. Right? Now let's consider the sign convention. Object. This is the pole. Right? Object is at infinity. Incident ray is from left to right. And here it will be measured in the opposite direction. And it's located at infinity. So u is minus infinity. R, students, the radius of curvature. The diameter of the flask is 15 cm. So radius of curvature would be PC. It is measured, PC is measured along the same direction as that of the incident ray. So it has to be taken as positive. So it will be half the diameter. That is plus 7.5 cm. And mu 1 is 1. Mu 2 is that of water, which is 4 by 3. So let's substitute these values over here. So what we get is minus mu 2 is 4 by 3. U is infinity. Plus mu 1 is 1. V is to be found. 1 minus 4 by 3 divided by r is 7.5 or 15 by 2. Right? Anything divided by infinity is 0, isn't it? So, we are left with 1 by V is equal to 1 minus 4 by 3 divided by 7.5. So, that will give us 3 minus 4 by 3. So, that is minus 1 by 3 multiplied by 7.5. That is, V is equal to minus 7.5. into 3 divided by 1, or in other words, V is equal to minus 22.5 centimeter. Clear, students? Negative signs suggest that the image is formed on the same side as that of the object. Object is traveling in the denser medium, so image is also formed in the denser medium. So the nature of the image is virtual. Clear? So therefore, the parallel beam of light will appear to come from point I, which is the virtual image as shown in this particular figure. Okay, now let's proceed to question number 4. This is the figure which is already given and it shows a solid glass sphere of radius 5 cm. Right? It has a small air bubble O trapped at a distance 2 cm from the center C. So, from the center C, this is a small air bubble which is at a distance of 2 cm from the center of curvature. Now, refractive index of the glass, it's given to be 1.5. This is mu 2. So, this is the adjacent medium is air, so it is mu 1 is equal to 1. So, we are supposed to find the apparent position of the bubble where it will appear when seen through the surface of the sphere from an outside point E. E is the eye, it is the observer's eye, right? This is the object. At this surface, the refraction will take place, so this will be considered as the pole. So, the distance of the object from the pole would be 3 cm. This is 5. This distance is 5. This distance is 2 cm, isn't it? So, obviously, this distance from the pole to the object, it would be 3 cm. Now, let's draw the ray diagram, students. Let us consider this to be the point where the refraction is to be discussed. So, first and foremost, we need to draw a normal, a dotted line passing through the center of curvature and that point on the surface represents the normal, right? This is the normal. This is the incident ray, students. OA is the incident ray. This will be the angle of incidence, isn't it? Rays traveling from denser to rarer medium. So, it will bend away from the normal like this. So, this is the refracted ray. The angle which the refracted ray makes with the normal is the angle of refraction. And when the ray of light is incident from the object normally at the pole, it will remain undeviated. So, it will be like this. So, these are the two refracted rays. These two rays, when enters the eye, retina of the eye, it will appear as if these two rays are coming from a point somewhere over here. Produce it also in the backward direction. So, this is where the image would be obtained. Right? So, the image is formed on the same side as that of the object. So, from the ray diagram, it's pretty evident that the image must be of virtual nature. Right? So, when seen from here, the air bubble will appear to be slightly raised up due to the refraction phenomena. So, here the object is in the denser medium. The incident ray is traveling in the denser medium. So, the formula to be used over here is minus mu 2 over u plus mu 1 over v is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 by r. That is, we are again supposed to make use of the formula which is applicable when the object is placed in a denser medium. Right? So, let's substitute the values and first write the sign convention. Object is over here. So, incident ray is traveling along this direction. This is the direction of the incident ray. And as you are aware, as per the sign convention, all the distances are to be measured from the pole. So, PO, it is measured against the direction of the incident ray. So, U is to be taken as negative. And PO, students, it is equal to 3 cm. This is 5, this is 2. So, it will be equal to 3 cm. So, U is minus 3 cm. V, it is to be calculated. Radius of curvature, right? So, in this case, radius of curvature would be, it's given to be 5 cm in magnitude. Now, incident ray is traveling from right to left, while PC is measured from left to right. So, in a direction opposite to that of the incident ray. So, it has to be taken as negative. Mu 1 is 1 and mu 2 is 1.5. So, let's substitute these values. So, what we get is 1.5 divided by u is minus 3 plus mu 1 is 1, v is to be calculated. Right? Which implies that minus minus get cancelled, so we get 1.5 divided by 3 plus 1 by V is equal to minus 0.5 divided by minus 5, which further implies that 1 by V is equal to minus minus get cancelled. So here we'll be left with 1 by 10 and minus this decimal gets eliminated, so it will become 15 by 30, so it is half. So 10 can be taken as LCM, so 1 minus 5, so it is minus 4 by 10, or it is 1 by V is minus 4 by 10, or V it would be equal to minus 10 by 4, so that will give us minus 2.5 centimeter. So students, the image will be formed at a distance of 2.5 centimeter from the pole, right? So PI, this distance is 2.5, and this negative sign suggests that the nature of the image obtained is virtual. Students, now let's attempt question number 5. The refractive index of air with respect to glass is 2 by 3. So refractive index of air with respect to glass is given by 2 by 3. The refractive index of diamond with respect to air is, the refractive index of diamond with respect to air is given to be 12 by 5. Now we are supposed to find out the refractive index of glass with respect to the diamond. This is to be found. So students, here we will make use of the formula which we have obtained while doing the article of refraction through multiple medium. This is the relative refractive index. We know that the relative refractive index of glass with respect to diamond is given by the absolute refractive index of glass divided by the absolute refractive index of diamond. Clear, students? Now, the refractive index of air with respect to glass is 2 by 3. Which implies that the refractive index of glass with respect to air would be equal to reciprocal of refractive index of air with respect to glass. That would be equal to 1 divided by 2 by 3. So that will give us 3 by 2, isn't it? So here let's substitute the value. Refractive index of glass with respect to air is 3 by 2. And refractive index of diamond with respect to air, it's given to be 12 by 5. So that will give us 3 by 2 multiplied by 5 by 12. So we get 5 by 8. Here I must mention the refractive index of a rarer medium with respect to denser medium. It will be always less than 1. While on the other hand, the refractive index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium, that will be always greater than 1. Here between glass and diamond, glass will act as the rarer medium and diamond will act as the denser medium. Clear? So the refractive index of glass with respect to diamond is found to be 5 by 8. Now let's proceed to question number 6. It's a conceptual question, students. The question is, for the same angle of incidence, that is, I is given to be constant, the angles of refraction in three different media, A, B and C, are 15 degree, 25 degree and 35 degree respectively. In which medium will the velocity of light be maximum? Right? This is to be determined. Now students, we are aware that refractive index of a medium is defined as the ratio of the velocity of light in air or vacuum to the velocity of light in that particular medium, right? This is the first formula that we are aware of. Or students, you can write like this also. V is equal to C divided by mu. Since C is constant, therefore, the velocity is inversely proportional to the reciprocal of the refractive index of the medium. The higher the value of refractive index of the medium, the smaller will be the speed of light in that particular medium, and vice versa. Also students, we all are aware of Snell's law. It states that the refractive index of the denser medium with respect to rarer medium is ratio of the sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction. Isn't it? So here students, for given value of I, for given value of I, angle of incidence is same in all the three cases. So mu is equal to 1 by sin r. Isn't it? Now, RA is less than, in medium A, the angle of refraction is 15 degree. RB, which in turn is less than angle of refraction in medium C. Therefore, students, it's inversely proportional, isn't it? So, sin RA is less than sin RB, which in turn is less than sin RC, which further implies that mu, it's inversely proportional to the sine of the angle of refraction. Therefore, mu A is greater than mu B, which in turn would be greater than mu C. Now consider these two. As I've told you, the higher the value of refractive index of the medium, the smaller will be the speed of light in that particular medium, isn't it? So, refractive index of medium A is highest. Therefore, velocity of light in medium A would be minimum. Right? While velocity of light in medium B would be greater than VA. And in medium C, the velocity of the light would be maximum. So students, the velocity of the light will be maximum in medium C. Clear? This is what we have obtained. Now, let's proceed to the last question. A ray of monochromatic light, mono means single, so single wavelength, a source of light emitting single wavelength or light of a particular wavelength is known as a monochromatic source of light. So, a ray of monochromatic light traveling in vacuum with speed c, wavelength lambda and frequency nu enters a medium of refractive index 1.5, right? So, refractive index of the medium is given to be 1.5. We are supposed to calculate its nu speed, wavelength and frequency. Now, students, if we consider v with the speed of light in the medium of refractive index mu equals to 1.5, then just now we have discussed refractive index is given by the ratio of the speed of light in air vacuum to the speed of light in that particular medium. Or v would be given by C by nu, isn't it? C by nu. Nu is the refractive index. C by mu. So, what we get is, velocity, it would be equal to C. Mu, the value of mu, which is the refractive index of the medium, it's given to be 1.5. So, students, the velocity, or rather the speed of the light in a medium when it enters, is V equals to C by 1.5. This is the answer of the first part. Right? Now, second is, students, always remember, either during reflection or refraction, it is the frequency of light that remains constant or it remains unchanged. So, the frequency of light in the medium will remain same, that is nu only, it will remain nu only, that is it will remain unchanged or it remains constant. Even when light travels from one medium to another medium, it is only the frequency that remains constant. The wavelength and the speed of the light get changed when it travels from one medium to another medium, but the frequency remains same. So this is a key point. Frequency is always constant. So frequency is constant means energy possessed remains constant. E equals to h nu. So frequency constant means energy also remains constant. Right? Now, students, if you consider lambda dash be the wavelength of the light in the medium, then since we know that velocity is given by the product of frequency and wavelength. So, in the medium, we get velocity in the medium is V. It is equal to frequency will remain unchanged. And the wavelength in the medium is lambda dash. Therefore, students, lambda dash is equal to V by nu. Now, V, as you are aware, it is given by C by 1.5, isn't it? So, what we get is V is equal to C divided by 1.5 nu. Now, C is also equal to nu lambda. So, it is nu lambda. Lambda is the original wavelength. So, nu nu get cancelled. So, the wavelength of the light when it enters the medium of refractive index 1.5 will become lambda divided by 1.5. So, this is the answer of the third part. So, what we have noticed is that when the light enters from one medium to another medium, then the velocity of the light get changed, the wavelength of the light also get changed, but the frequency always remains constant. The velocity of the light in the medium would be equal to C by refractive index, while the new wavelength of the light when it enters the medium would be lambda, original wavelength, divided by refractive index. So that's the formula to be used. So students, I hope you have benefited from these questions, and do practice more and more such questions. It is only through practice that you can feel confident about doing numericals and solving numericals, right? So that's it for this particular session, students. Do take very good care of yourself and keep watching my videos. Thank you.